once again to my little corner of YouTube and another daily video. So today I've got an older issue of Vogue magazine. This is British Vogue and this one is dated December 2013. So it's a Christmas issue-ish. I think it's a Christmas issue because it's December. On the cover we've got the amazing Camos. It's also a designer special at home, at work, at play. Bringing sexy back, dare to pair dressing, and the best luxury underwear. Game of Thrones, Khaleesi, Dusty Or, and high-tech heroines, the Silicone Valleys. Wives and girlfriends. On the other side, we've got a galaxy of British fashion stars and guest fashion editor, John Galliano. Let's get into it and see what we think. Got Estee Lauder, a modern muse, the inspiring new fragrance. Triple page ad. Got Gucci. More Gucci. And Dior, or Christian Dior. With Chanel.
Super relaxed.
Behind every great look, there's an even greater set of underwear. Serena Lord admires this season's prettiest performers. shaping the future of shopping. And LFW's special view from the front row is often the showgoers who set the style agenda for the season, presenting the need-to-know trends to work now. Rise and Shine, Vogue's jewellery editor Carol Walton, swaps watch, trailer, whatever that says, I don't know, sorry guys, for a spot of daytime sparkles, selling gems on QVC. I have to keep apologising for my pronunciation, sometimes I just don't know what to say. The words just don't come out how I want them to sound. Crazy, but that's the way it is, unfortunately. I like this watch. Vivienne Westwood time machine. I didn't know Vivienne Westwood did watches. Vogue, there is no finer time to take stock and celebrate. Here's the style, a toast to British fashion and its galaxy of star creatives, and a tribute to global designers from here to New York to Paris. Dress up in all-out opulence, try regal ruffs and puffs laced with luxurious pearls of fabulously fizzling jewels. Our favourite kind of baubles, all fit for a queen, really, how better to cheer a great fashion year. Made in Britain, Christmas is the time we traditionally return to our roots. Photographer Tim Walker gathers Britain's brightest and best in this portfolio of his homegrown styles and celebrates the immense fashion heritage of our unique isles. So I've got Jean Campbell, J.W. Anderson, Gareth Pugh, Simone Rocha, and Sam Rawlinson. She's got the knockout body and sultry sophistication of all great sex bombs. But is Lea Seydoux ready to become a lesbian pinup by Jo Ellison? She's very pretty. Fantasia, the spirits of the ballet Russes and Malcolm McLaren hover over the set as John Galliano, Vogue's guest fashion editor, duets with Kate Moss and describes his vision. Kate Moss seems to look like just absolutely amazing in anything. Always been a fan. Treasures. Dragon Lady. tune, rock and call, Rihanna Mac Lipstick launched in New York, selling out in record-breaking 3 hours. Meanwhile in London, makeup artist Charlotte Tilbury launched her assault on the beauty world with the House of Rock and Call, a pop-up event in Selfridges. And November Picture Perfect. There are so many beauty collaborations these days. It's a rare one that gets us really infused, but Nars' collection honouring the greatest inspiration photographer Guy Borden. Yes, please. And Breathing Colour. The evocative scents and shining hues of Christmas in grass are the inspiration behind L'Occitane's newest fragrance. Present and Correct. Beauty Halls on Christmas Eve and Madness. Mayhem and Saviours, but what really goes on behind those counters? Kathleen Bedd, Murray Dexel. Rimmel, Out of This World. Kate Moss again, she looks absolutely amazing, those lips. Wow, like absolutely beautiful. Gorgeous.